Hello crafters, welcome to my channel. Can you see lots of punches on my table today? Yes. So this is the introductory video about the punches I have, and you will see the different varieties of punches today in my video. Are you excited to see this? I have usually used all these punches in my projects. So I will show you each and every product one by one with a detailed procedure that how to use this. So first I am starting with these small size punches. So there are different varieties in these punches. These are the smallest ones. So I have this butterfly punch, the star punch and the flower punch. You can use these punches to decorate your greeting cards. These are medium sized punches. So I have one more flower, heart punch and the 8 petal flower. Now these are large size punches. This is the 5 petal flower. And I have recently used this flower in my project. I will show you. I have created this newspaper wall hanging, and the decoration of the outer edge has been done using the same punch. This is the leaf punch. This is one more flower. This is the balloon which I usually use in my birthday projects. This is the large size heart punch. Now these three are extra large punches. So I have flower one, heart punch and this 6 petal flower. So now I will show you one secret technique to use these punches. Now I'm taking this 100 GSM A4 size paper. This is the best quality paper to use your punches. Now just tuck the paper inside the punch and you will get a beautiful 6 petal flower. But here you can see approx 1 cm paper is getting wasted each time you punch. So to save this paper each time, I have one secret trick. Just take any kind of tape and add this tape on this edge from both the sides. So this tape will stop the extra paper to come inside the punch when you will use it. This technique I got from my teacher. Now when you will insert the punch, see, the less amount of paper is getting wasted each time. I think that technique will help you to save the paper. You can see the difference of the paper. So each time you will get the same flower, but the less wastage of paper. Now this is the border punch I have. This is a small size border punch. You just need to insert in the paper. So you will get a beautiful flower. Now manually you need to align the punch with the design and punch it again. So in this way you can create the beautiful border to decorate your craft projects like this. Now you can just cut the paper around this. And also you can use these hearts for other projects. Cut the excess paper. So now you have ready designer punch border. Now I have this corner punch which also can be used as a border punch. Now just take any paper, insert your corner paper inside this punch. So there are angles inside the sponge. So you just need to line up the corner with this angle, punch it, so you will get a beautiful corner punch design. Now to create the border using this punch, you just need to pull these two flaps from left and right side. And now normally just insert this punch from the paper and punch it. Now align it with the design and continue this till the end. Now cut excess paper. So you will get a beautiful border design. So this punch you can use as a border punch or as a corner punch. And now you can again attach these side panels to use it as a corner. So this is about this punch. Now I have this grid decoration punch. So you can just use it as a grid decoration, or you can also create the border using this. And this is having the storage box on back side of the punch, so the all extra scrap papers will collect inside this box. So again I'm making one border using this punch. And all the scrap paper will get stored inside this. So you just clean it and it's again ready to use for the next border design. Now I have this jumbo large butterfly punch which I usually use in my projects. I love this punch very much. You will get a beautiful butterfly from this punch. Now I have these medium size border punches. These are very useful to decorate your scrapbooks or albums, greeting cards, many projects. So I will show you how to use these border punches one by one. So I am starting with this one. Take one paper. Just align the paper with the border. Now on left side align the design with the back side design and punch it, and just continue this till the end. So you will get a beautiful border design. Now you can just trim it. So you have one border punch. Now I am repeating the same process with the other punches to show you the different patterns. Like this. Now I am showing the last one. This is the small heart punch which I recently got from the local store, but these all punches are available online. Like this. Now cut the excess paper and you have beautiful border to decorate your projects. So these three patterns which I have shown, I have used these patterns recently on this mini scrapbook, and inside the scrapbook I have added this medium one. Now this is a large size border punch from AK Tools. This is little heavy in weight, and backside you will get a notch, so you just need to press it to open the punch. Now insert any paper inside this and just follow the guideline to align it and get a perfect border. For this you need little heavyweight paper, so here I am using 150 GSM paper. See how intricate the border design. This is very beautiful. I love this. And I have recently used this border punch in my quill calendar. I have decorated all the months, days and dates using this same border punch design. I have just used the black color paper for this. So this is the extra large border punch. Now here is my favorite one. This is from Martha Stewart Craft and this is the heart punch, and I have used this punch many times in my project. You just need to open the package, open both side flaps. This is little heavy in weight, but it gives the crisp border each time. See how beautiful and intricate heart pattern you will get each time. Beautiful. Now I'm just cutting the strip to get a border design. Like this. And I have recently used this border in my anniversary special album. So I have added this border on the album, and also I have added inside the album. I just used the black color paper for this. So this is about the heart lace punch, and this is the jumbo border punch, which gives you a large border design. And from this jumbo pattern, I can create the design around the paper as well. So you just need to line it up according to the guideline, like this. Isn't it beautiful? And to create the corner design, just line up the side paper with this line. The guideline has been given on the punch, and just punch it. So you will get this corner pattern as well. So you can create frame using this punch. Now I have one more Martha Stewart Crafts punch, and using this punch you can create the corner design, the border design or the design all around the page to create the frames. So with this packaging you will get one instruction page on which you will get the different sizes of papers to create the border all around the paper. So for today's project I am using 5 inches by 5 inches square paper. This is 12.7 centimeter paper. They give very nice packaging for your punches, so you can keep these punches safely in your collection. First, I am taking this border punch, open this side flap, and this is the corner punch. First, I am punching all four corners. See how beautiful the corner looks. So you can use the paper only by using these corner punches. And if you want the border all around the paper, so you just need to line up the corner design with this side panel. See, they have given this design. So you have to line up this design with your punch and just press it like this. So continue this for all over the border. Like this. So you will get a beautiful punched border frame to your paper. You can add photographs inside this and create the frame. You can use this inside the scrapbook or explosion boxes. And this is all about this punch. I have recently used this border punch on my hexagon box. I have added this border on upper and lower side. Now this is the punch to round your paper from the corner. So these are having three different dimensions, 7 mm, 4 mm and 10 mm. First I am showing you 7 mm. See, you will get a beautiful 7 mm round corner. This is the 4 mm. And this is the 10 mm. This is very useful for the scrapbooking or album making. I have recently used this 10 mm corner chopper in my Diwali sentiment tags. If you remember, I have shown earlier all these 10 different types of Diwali sentiment. So this is about the corner punch. So all the punches in different variety I have tried to show you today. I have some more punches other than these, but all the basic concept behind these punches are the same. So hope I have cleared the doubt regarding the punches, and if you have any extra questions, you can ask me freely in comment section. So my project is done for today. Hope you enjoyed my video. Please subscribe my channel for more interesting videos and please click on bell icon for the latest updates. Thanks for watching. See you next time. Bye-bye.